to us sometimes, are we not? That's why we're searching for peace so often. But to do justice, to love kindness, and to walk humble with our God is what peace is about. Do not oppress the poor is what peace is about. Taking care of your enemies, loving thy enemies is the peace that we're looking for. The peace that we're looking for is where you don't have to acquire so much land that you acquire more than yours. It even says in the Bible, let me see, it says it in Isaiah 5:8, it says, "And do not let some acquire so much of God's earth for themselves that others are left out." In other words, you're trying to acquire things of this world. You're trying to acquire money and wealth and land. And I'm not talking about having land to raise cattle. I'm not at all. I'm just talking about keep acquiring and acquiring just to be acquiring so you put your name on it. God says, don't do that. Don't take from your brothers just to build yourself up. You follow me? Why? Because he's telling you how to achieve peace. And if you keep acquiring land, you're not going to have peace. Don't make sense to the world, does it? But that's what the Bible's telling us. Don't try to grab everything. Don't be obsessive. How many in here give a gift for Christmas? Give a gift to somebody for Christmas. Are you mad because you give that gift? Imagine that. That's not of the world. I'm telling you. Giving is from the Spirit. Our spirit is right with God. Our spirit is right with God. He lives inside of us. The Holy Spirit is there with our spirit. So we want to live rightly. The flesh is what we have to overcome, and we need to give our hearts. So when we give a gift, it's godly when we give, right? So why wouldn't we feel good? Now, I've heard a lot of people, and I'm guilty myself, say, boy, I'd feel a lot better if I just poke that old boy in the nose. I'm tired of his mouth. But after you poke him, you might feel okay for a little bit, but you know, really, it kind of gets to you. You finally find out, well, why did I hit that guy in the nose? He's just a big sissy. You see what I'm trying to say? When you do things not from God, if you do things that's outside of what God has aligned us to do, you really get no enjoyment out of it in the long run. When you're shooting up with drugs, it's an instant and it's a short-term high. Get filled with the Holy Spirit and guess what happens? Woohoo! I can be happy all the time. Years ago, there was a movement come out of Florida about a spirit of laughing. And these preachers, there was a few anointed to do that, and they'd go to these churches, and they would preach, and the whole congregation would just end up laughing. Well, you know, being a good Baptist boy, I'm thinking, that's not that bad. I'm going to go check this out. I laughed for 45 minutes. And the dude wasn't that funny. It was a God thing. It was a gift that God was giving his people at that time. Peace is a gift that God gave us. We have to accept it, just like all God's gifts. We have to accept peace. So the peace of the world is not what we think it is it? Maybe we think it's because we're not fighting together, but God says it's so much more than just that. You know, Jesus says, treat others the same way you want them to treat you. Luke 6:31. That's where you find peace. Love your neighbors as yourself. You'll find peace. Prophet Jeremiah spoke of all God's faithfulness in every age when he said this, saying, peace, peace, but there is no peace. He's talking about how we fail to grab a hold of the peace. Why? Because we're trying to do it ourselves. The Don't even look up at me. For an example, you grab a hold of that fifth and boy, you're drinking. And you know, you get that peace kind of. You're really getting drunk. You're losing your senses. It seems like it's fun, maybe. And a few hours later, when you're at the altar, the porcelain altar, there's no peace, is there? No, it hurts. You see, folks, all these things in the world that we're trying to find peace or find happiness with is the same thing. It's going to lead us to a place where it's not peaceful. Unless we accept that free gift and we give glory to those who give. And that's God Almighty. Amen? I don't know about you all, but I crave for peace. I crave for that peace that God has for us. But as I get older, that peace starts to come a little faster. As I continue to try to live my life as God would have me to live it, I get a little bit more peace. These guns that got stole from me, I'm just about over it. The devil will come smack on me a little bit every once in a while, and I want to go kill somebody, or I think I do. You know what? It's almost over. Last time I had a gun stole, I never got over it till I got the gun back, and I did some things I shouldn't have done. Peace is okay. It'll come. When you get mad at somebody because they've taken money from you or you think you've got messed over on a business deal, listen, God can replace it sevenfold, can he not? What's he say to do for those people? Forgive them 7 times 70. 7 times 7. Seven's what? Perfect number. You know what that means? Forgive them, forgive them, forgive them, forgive them, forgive them, forgive them. Forgive them, forgive them. Why? Because he knows if you can forgive them, peace will come. And he'll repay it. It may not be in your time. Let me ask you this. How much money would you pay to have a sense of spiritual peace right now? How much? I'd give everything I had. I wouldn't give my wife and daughter away. But the house may go. I would give a lot of money for spiritual peace, true peace. And Jesus says, and God, the Bible leads us to believe on this concept of peace, there's a couple of things we just got to do. And first of all, we put God first, right? And then the other one is what? Love others as you love yourself. You know, we have the Ten Commandments, and they're all good, and they're good guidelines for us, and God wants us to hang on to them and do those things. And he's given us a lot of other commands in the Bible, and he wants us to follow those commands. They're like an outline for a life. But you know what he really tells us? He said, do these two things, and all those commandments, all the laws of the prophets, in other words, everything that's been told for you to do in your walk with Christ, your walk with God, your walk on earth, your walk in this fleshy body, if you can do these two things, love God, love your neighbor as yourself, guess what? You'll take care of all the rest. If you can do those two things, guess what happens? Peace will come. That wasn't always true. That wasn't true in the Old Testament. That didn't happen in the Old Testament. What happened there is totally different than what we're in here. We're under the new covenant. We're under the covenant that Jesus Christ has already paid for our sins. Jesus Christ has already opened up that door for us to go for the Father. Jesus Christ has already set in motion this peace that you can have. That when Jesus Christ came, that day in Bethlehem, when that baby showed up, there was a promise given, peace on earth, goodwill towards men. Lordy, 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 it's easy. Peace. I don't know about you, but peace is important to me. I've been a man of war. Peace is important to me. I've been a man that drank. Peace is good. Peace is what I look for. I've been a violent person. Peace is what I desire. Nothing that I've said makes me any different than anybody else. I was a man of the world. you too have been a man of the world or a woman of the world. But God wants to give you peace. God's Son was the Prince of Peace. Isaiah 9:6. John 1:14 says, God spoke peace and the world God spoke became flesh and lived among us. You hear that? John 1:14 says, God spoke peace and the word God spoke became flesh and lived among us. Who's peace? Who? Jesus. God spoke peace, and peace come in the flesh and lived among us. That day of Bethlehem was the greatest two gifts that God could ever give His people, eternal life through Jesus Christ and peace. Whew. It seems simple, isn't it? It's very simple, but we're not grabbing a hold of it as individuals. It's kind of a deep concept when you start thinking about peace. You know, preachers will tell you all the time, come up here and give your life to Christ and everything will be right. That's halfly true, isn't it? When you accept Jesus Christ, everything will be right between you and God. But Satan's not done beating on you, is he? You remember all them bad things you did? He can't forgive you. Didn't he say that? Doesn't Satan do that? Am I the only one that fights with Satan about my salvation? The Bible says, work out your own salvation. Why? You got to beat up on the devil a little bit. You can't take this from me. It's a free gift. And until you get to the point where you realize it's not about emotions, it's not about feelings, although God is all into that, I'm just telling you, it's not all about that. What it's really about is knowing God's Word, doing what He says, and saying, you know what, Satan? The Word of God says this. The Word of God gave me righteousness before God. The Word of God gave me peace. Now be gone. We need to grab that and hold on to it. When you start getting frustrated, start grabbing a hold of peace. Man, your preacher's preaching to himself. I get all worked up. Ask John, I get fired up. But now I know in the Word of God it says I have peace. We must look for peace, right? God is good. And all the time, do you want peace? Another thing is, peace can't be imposed or pushed on us from the top down. In other words, peace doesn't come from emperors, kings, dictators, and presidents. It can't happen. It's they've tried to do it through the annals of history, and it's never come about. Nor can peace be brought into existence from the bottom up. Because of revolutions and rebellions just replace one form of violence with another. No, peace cannot come from top down or bottom up. It can only come from inside out. It must begin in the human heart. And it comes from knowing Jesus Christ and allowing the Holy Spirit to fill your life with the promise of peace. And it comes from knowing that baby that was born on Bethlehem that day. The same baby that the angel said, hark, peace on earth. Thus the path to peace lies in emulating the man that baby become. That man, Jesus Christ. He was sent to be an example for our peace. He spoke God's nature. He lived God's nature. If God is love kindness, God is love, Jesus was love. And because of that love, we have peace. But yet, We look to our own devices many times to try to find peace, don't we? Man, I've had some good times sinning. But it never paid off, did it? I'll fight toe-to-toe with any preacher that'll tell you, well, sinning's no fun. Sometimes sinning's fun. I'm not going to hide nothing from you. You know that. I know that. If I tell you anything different, you're going to think, oh, anything holier than thou. I'm going to tell you, there's times when sinning's fun. But it never pays off. It never brings peace, does it? I'm sorry, folks. I got to tell you how important this word peace is. This is a gift that the church is overlooking. This is a gift that was so important that day at Bethlehem that the angels spoke of it. They didn't say, hark, your salvation has come. Although in a way they did. They didn't go, hark, the Holy Spirit's yet to, almost to come. Hark. No, they said, hark, peace on earth. Do you understand this? God wants you to have peace. He wants you to have peace so much that He sent His only living God, Son. He loves you so much. He wants you to have peace so much that His Son went to the cross and died for you. He wants peace so much that He made it free to you and I. Well, how do I get it? First step is, you must accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Second one is, follow His commandments. And which if we're going to follow His commandments, what do we got to follow? Love God first, love others as myself, right? If we can do those two, all the others are coming. So really, this Christian walk, seeing, it's pretty simple to lay out. I could probably lay it out on one piece of paper. But it's a lot more than that, isn't it? So you think you're tough? You think you're a bad man? Become a Christian. See if you can walk that walk. When a guy steals from you, how do you pray for him? Huh? Do you say, God bless him? Or do you say, vengeance is mine? God says, vengeance is His. Chris tells a story about Dennis Aaron telling him, I'll pray for him, just pray for him. How do you pray for a guy that just stole this money from you? It's easy. God bless him. I don't know how God bless him. He may knock him plumb down. Yeah? Peace is a gift, and it's free. Let's go to the Lord in prayer real quick. Lord, Father, I just love you so very much, and I thank you. I thank you for the gift of peace. We pray today that all the empty and aching corners of our heart will be filled with peace. That peace that surpasses all understanding. Let the peace of Christ within us govern our relationship with our family, our friends, and those that we come in contact in this world, even our enemies. Let that peace be foremost. Let Christ's peace lift us up above the pressures and traumas and things of this world that we face, Lord, that we may be more than conquerors through Him who loves us, living gracefully and victoriously through all of our lives, changing circumstances by a peaceful way. And let His peace within us remove all fear as we face the uncertainties of life, even the greater uncertainty of death, Lord, that may come. Lord, whatever's going on, the Muslim movement, Lord, let us find peace through You and not have fear on those. Lord, let us find peace in You on no matter what our living situation is, Lord. Let us have peace. Oh, gracious God who speaks of peace on earth and goodwill to people, we pray as well that all the world shall be filled with peace. And those children that go without food and hunger. They hunger daily, Lord, that they may find peace, Lord. Let us put into action our claims of being a Christian, Lord. Let us bring peace to those that are without. Let us bring peace to those that are troubled in their lives, Lord. Let us bring peace to those that even cuss us, Lord. Let us speak blessings upon them, Lord, that they may come to know you. Let us truly live out the peace that you spoke in your word. Lord, let us bring harmony to every relationship we step into. Lord, I believe with all my heart that you can give us that peace, for it's been a promise. You give us that peace in the flesh named Jesus Christ. Our job is to accept. Lord, we just ask you to be with us. And Lord, I just ask you that if one person in here today requests you or requests that peace in their life, that you may touch them. This I ask in Jesus' name. Amen. With your head bowed and your eyes closed, let me just ask you a few questions. Are you seeking peace in your life? Have you been going to and fro, looking for things in the world, and still not having that peace? I'm here to tell you today that peace came over 2,000 years ago, and he's still here today. If you only accept him and his love for you, which will bring you a peace that surpasses all understanding. Is there issues in your life that you need to take care of? God says, I'm here. I've got peace for you. I ask you to make that move to turn it over to him. You can come up here. You can do it where you sit. But turn it over to God right now, whatever it may be. If Satan's playing with you right now, tell him to be gone in the name of Jesus Christ. You don't have time for him. You've been promised peace. You've been promised eternal life. You've been promised hope. Claim those things right now in the name of Jesus. Every head bowed and every eye closed, let me ask you, does anybody here need a special prayer? I just ask you to raise your hand, and I'll pray for you. Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Anybody else? Does anybody desire more peace? Thank you. Anybody? Thank you. God is real. Lord, Father, we ask you so much to bless these that raise their hand, Lord. You know every situation in their life right now. Lord, you know what they need. They need peace. They need your assistance. They need your guidance, Lord. And you promise that you'll do that, Lord, and we stand on that promise. Satan, we tell you right now in the name of Jesus Christ to be gone from these people's lives. Father, just I pray that you just put a protection around them and give the angels the things that they need to fight the spiritual battle, and that you protect them right now. And Lord, I just pray for a special feeling, a special anointing of the Holy Spirit right now fall on everyone here today, that they may have a new taste of the peace that come over 2,000 years ago, that this peace fills us right now in our spirits, Lord, and that we just start to put on a smile and knowing that we've got eternal life. And that whatever's going on in this world is not here forever. That it's only for a short time. That we can have peace right now in the flesh, Lord. And waiting for that ultimate peace. When we meet with you, Lord. And when we're in your presence. Lord, we love you. And we need you. And we thank you. That you love us. Anybody else? Anybody? Carry that cross for him. On that rugged walk he
I love you, brother.
what shall I give him today? He wants my heart more than he asked for my wage. One day I'll die, but it won't be my last day. When I look in his eyes, I'll know that I did hope.